This video is going to show you how to calculate enthalpy using bond energy. Enthalpy, or delta H, is equal to the sum of the heat, or the energy to break your bonds, minus the sum of your bonds formed. Remember, breaking bonds is endothermic, that's positive. Forming bonds is exothermic, that's why this is negative. There's another calculation to do enthalpy. It's using heat of formations, and that's products minus reactants. This is different. Using bond energy, we'd say broken minus form because it's going to be reactants minus products, and we don't want to confuse those. So here's a reaction we're going to make: water from hydrogen and oxygen. First step is to actually draw your bonds. So we have two hydrogens and then oxygen. Now remember, oxygen has a double bond and water has your bent or angular shape. So there we go. These are broken, these are formed. Now all we have to do is a little bookkeeping. So we have two hydrogen-hydrogen bonds, and we're going to look up the energy for that. That's 436, and if we multiply that out, that's what, 872. And then oxygen with the double bond, we have one of those, and oxygen is 499. And this adds up to, let's see, 1, 7, and 13. Okay, now that's the energy to go in. That's the positive part. Now this side is going to be your negative part. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 OH bonds. So 4 times 463, and that comes out to, let's see, that's 2, 5, or the 2, 18. So we have 1371 minus 1852. This is going to be a negative number. So we'll just take out our calculator. 1371 minus 1852, and our delta H is equal to negative 481 kilojoules, and that's it. We don't put per mole because there's a 2 here, it's per 2 moles. So that's how you do your delta H for the combustion of hydrogen. Now we're going to do the combustion of propane. Now what you should know is any combustion, delta H is going to be negative, so if you don't have it as a negative, you did something wrong. So here's propane, CH3CH2CH3. Reacts with 5 moles of O2 and it forms 3 moles of CO2 and 4 moles of water. I broke it down, you see the bonds already. Now it's time for bookkeeping. So you just gotta count. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 CH bonds, and CH is 413, so we'll just mark those off. We have two CC bonds, and that's going to be 347, and 5 oxygen double bonded, and what does it say here? 498. That's interesting. The other one was 499. All right, whatever. So 8 times 413, what is that? 3304. And 2 times 347 is 694, and 5 times 498, well, 2500 minus 10 is 2490, and then we add that up, we get 8 carry the 1, and we get 6488 for the breaking side. Now we gotta add up this side. We have 3 CO2s, so that really means we have 6 COs. And CO is valued at 815, not 815, 805. So 805 times 6, what is that, 840, and then we have 4, water is linear now. That should be actually bent, but that means we have 8 OHs, so 8 times 464, so that's going to be, let's see, 2, 1, 3712. Okay, and when we add this up, let's see, 2, 4, 5, 8. Now all we have to do is broken minus formed. So I'll just that minus 8542. And that's going to give us, let's see, 6488 divided by 1 minus 8542. And we get negative 2,054, and that's kilojoules. And that's how you use enthalpy to find bond energy.